Hey guys, I decided to upload a tutorial of how to draw one of the new things on my page, on my DeviantArt page, and I'll link that in the description. And the thing that we're going to be drawing is, let me bring it up here for you guys. My Poro. Now, Poros are incredibly simple, so this video isn't going to take long. It's just the first in a series of videos that I'm going to show you how to do stuff like this. Well, first thing we're going to do is we're going to keep our Poro over here as a reference. And yes, I signed my name in the corner. My name's Caitlin. Pleasure to meet you all, and I hope you all enjoy the video. Okay. So we're going to make a new canvas. It doesn't really matter the size. Now I have mine a 9x11. And I have it on 50 zoom. Now let's get a little bit closer and figure out the basic shape of the Poro. Now you're going to want to start with a dark black so you can get the shapes in. Start with the big oval like body, kind of like a rock. Alright. Then we're going to do back leg, and back leg, like that. I probably could edit this a little bit. These are just the base shapes. Front leg, another front leg, probably ends like there. And that part is a little bit too small. Because it has to hold up the whole Poro. The Poros can get huge. If you played League, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And then put in one of these big, beautiful, beady eyes. Just a circle for now. And we're going to do this just happy, go lucky expression, which is all the way to the other side. Maybe curve it up a little bit more, make it, well, a little bit less, and make it last longer. There we go. We're going to draw a big T, because Poros are carnivores. And Poro snacks are made of the souls of children, as me and my friends have decided that's what they're made of. Yeah, I know. A little creepy, but that's where my friends are. That's that. And then the other T's, right there. And a little bit of the eye coming off. And Poro looks pretty decent so far. Then we're going to do the horn. We're not going to show the other horn because it's on the complete opposite side of the body. We are going to be able to. I'm actually going to move this back a tiny bit. More like there. This is just going to be where the horn connects to the body. Now we're going to make. And you can make your horns slightly curvier or straighter. Would be the proper word for that. I like having big, thick, curvy horns, typically, on all of my characters, but since we're drawing from a very well-known character, or animal, or whatever you want to call it, which, it's an adorable little animal, you have to kind of follow what the thing is. Now we're gonna draw a circle so you can see where the face is, where the face ends, which would probably have shorter fur, where the rest of the body is. Now, let's put in some line work. Alright, now we have our base shape. What we're going to want to do with this base shape is, well, with the line tool, if you have access to it, you're going to want to start putting in that. Oh, actually, scratch that. We're not going to use the line tool. Bad idea. We're going to use the curve tool, actually. Because curves are more like hair follows more of a curve pattern than actual look. All of the hair is like curve. It's easier when you've actually got. I'm still having trouble with this, so I'm just gonna. You guys can use the curve tool, but I'm just gonna use a pen tool. Make it slightly bigger, and just start making my Poro fuzzy. Some simple pointed curves. Make sure it's curving around the body, too, because Poro is a circular. Well, somewhat circular shape. Make sure it's long for the covering onto the toes. And this all is in line work, and you can edit it when we actually go to color it. Well, fur is actually shorter around the body, and around the feet. That's probably so it doesn't freeze and get trip all over the frozen fur, the toes. Unlikely if that fur would freeze, but still. Fur gets a little bit shorter. Also maybe too long. Well, this is my first drawing video on YouTube, and you guys really like it so far. I'm gonna stop it around there when, well, not stop it. Keep going until we reach where the tongue would be. There's that tongue. And then the other side of the horn. Well, actually, let's draw how fur covers part of the horn. No, we're gonna draw. The horn is connected in there. And we're going to draw the fur that covers the horn. And I'm guessing it covers like that. You can do your own interpretation of how it covers it, but that seems pretty basic. Poros, to my knowledge, don't have ears. If they do, they're very tiny and covered by the rest of their fur, so you don't normally see Poro ears. I'm going to just go all the way around the Poro until we get back to his eye. Then we're gonna bring out his cheek here. Draw that line in. Curve this out. And now we're gonna draw his face. So we're gonna bring in that big, beautiful beady eye. This is adorable. And we're gonna ignore that line for now. That line's just this line that shows you the face is just for, well, to show you where you need to make the fur shorter when you get to, into the detail work. Get his expression in there. Make his teeth a little bit blunted because he's not sharp, sharp tooth. Well, they're not sharp, sharp tooth. With the tongue circular. Give his other tooth a little bit of less of a point. And we're gonna do his paw over here. And paw. That's all the way like that. Then we're gonna do his other paw. We're gonna draw in the line where the paw is separate. And now we're gonna do the paw over here. And I've always imagined Poros have three digits on all of their feet, so you want to draw the three digits if you want to do that, or four digits, or two digits, or no digits, if that's what you want. You can take artistic license with this. It's a lot of fun. I always have a lot of fun drawing characters like this. And I'll be showing you guys a few other things on my channel. I forgot we're in the wrong layer for that. But, basically, that's the line work so far. Oh, and the horn. We're gonna make sure that the horn is blunted and not sharp. Not sharp. Not sharp! Poros don't use their horns for self-defense because they don't need to. They're adorable, and everything on the Feliord loves them. Except for people, because people are. Well, people love them too, just. Not the way they need to be loved. Alright, and then we're going to draw in a few lines to show the curves of the horn. You can add as many or as few as you'd like. I like adding a few too many because it adds more interest to the piece. I'm going to hide that layer. Isn't it cute? Gonna, so far so good. Oh, we almost got, I think I draw out that eye shape. He does have a second eye. And it's visible. Just not as visible as his big eye. Now this Poro, of course, is not gonna look exactly like that Poro. Because there's artistic changes between each drawing. You're not gonna draw the same thing exactly twice. Unless you're really practicing it. Like, you might find it in a slightly different pose. Her amount might be slightly different. If you're doing horns, the horns might be slightly smaller, bigger. Curve might not be the same. There's curves in the horns. Well, we're going to delete this layer because we don't need it anymore. And we're going to start on the layer for color. I'm going to ignore that because it doesn't really matter right now. We're not going to color the actual Poro. We're just going to color the thing. So if you guys want, you can download my Poro. It's a free link. And we're going to just use the eyedropper tool. Take that color. Put it back into here and take a pen. When we're actually in another layer. Take the pen, start putting that in there. Now, this was one of my first drawings on the side, and using a tablet. If you're learning to use a tablet, this is a really cool way to learn how to use a tablet. Learning to draw some of your favorite video game characters is always a lot of fun. And I thought I would demystify the Poro myself. I had so much fun drawing him when I drew him first time. And I keep calling the Poro male. Well, I know it could be a female. Probably is because it explodes into more Poros when you feed it too many Poro snacks, but it's up to you what you think your Poro should be, a male or a female or I don't know. All we know from the lore and probably what we were told by Riot, is that it's a reindeer dog. Reindeers for the long, long, thick fur and the way the paws are shaped. And the dog is for the long tongue, cute smile, just overall cuddliness. Reindeer are probably not as nearly as loveful as our poor old friends. But they are still adorable. Very smart. And you have to be careful to make sure that their ears are the right color. Well, the horn's the right color versus the feet. Now, I'm using a Wacom tablet. And you can do this yourself by right-clicking. But I'll just show you something really cool. I can just use the eyedropper tool like that by pressing down on one of the top buttons on my Wacom. Now I'm grabbing that color for the horn segments. Make sure I get that in there nice and good. And then we're going to edit the line work after we're done. Yeah. And we're going to take a little color from this foot. Get that in the actual foot. Now this doesn't have any real shading. If you want to do a background, you can edit it so it looks more realistic, like he's actually on Howling Abyss, or in the Rift, or just in the middle of the tundra, like in the Braum trailer. Trying to find some food, some Poro snacks, because he's hungry. Or she, or whatever a Poro is. You don't know. At least I don't know. And I admit that, I don't know very much about what crows are, they're female or male. Now, before going on and moving into the other feet, Just make sure I have this clear. I have that. I'm actually going to draw the line to the toes on the other feet while I'm at it. And I decided to give the Poro slightly yellow teeth because I probably are. What is a reindeer dog gonna do for a dentist? I don't know. Maybe, I don't know, dentist sticks? I don't think they have that. So you'd think that their teeth would get a little bit of damage or just some miscoloration. No, I'm actually gonna fix that color because it's a little too light. I dragged on the wrong foot. Much better. Go back into your other color. Ah, that's still the other color. There we go. Better. Just color it in. You can even use a select pen and do a fill tool if you're on different software. But since I'm in Sci, I like doing all this tedious work, I'm just going to do this. And after we're done doing all the coloring, I'm going to redefine his fur and wear his paw. Just to make sure that it makes sense to the viewer of the piece. We're going to definitely keep that layer underneath this layer, because if you cover that layer, as long as it's not too much, it's not too much of a big deal, we can always pull the layer in front of it if we really want to. But we won't see nearly as much color. That's up to you if you want to do that. However you want your layers, you can have your layers. However you want your lines, you can have your lines. Alright, for now, we're going to start next with the yellow crystal. Now, Poros, because they live in Italy, don't have access to good pigments. So they keep this slightly yellow. Thank you. Adorable. I love Poros. Now, I'm not going to save this because I actually have a better Poro image. I like that Poro better than the one that I'm drawing now. So we're going to make sure and refine this stupid old... Well, I don't know if it's stupid, but this just dumb happy-go-lucky grin. And redefine that fur. And you'll notice in my version of the Poro, use gray to show the texture of the fur. You don't have to use that. You can just use black. It's all up to you what you want to do with that. Then we're going to do his eyes. And I enjoyed doing this. Taking a large size brush, just putting that dark circle in there. Then taking an eraser, going into a smaller circle, a slightly larger circle first. And just erasing that, there you go. You can change the position of your Poro's eye if you so wish. And at this point, we're going to add his tongue. Now, using the brush just a little too big. I'm gonna go and do this. And then redefine the mouth because I messed up the mouth. And the tongue. Get back to that dark black. Have lines. And now, because I don't feel like going for a real gray, I'm going to just start with a smaller brush, faintly adding in little lines. Sometimes you're going to want to split the hairs, add a little bit of texture to them. All up to you how you do this step. The steps the most up your creativity, because you can add as much detail or as little detail as you want. I personally love high detail, so I am adding high detail. remember where that line was? We're gonna just make sure that the fur in the face is just a little shorter, and the front under the chin as well. So let's imagine this is an invisible line around the Poro's face. Because no animal has really, really long hair around their face except for English shepherds and stuff like that. And that's because they were bred that way. But in the Arctic, you don't have things like that. And Poro is designed in the Arctic. We're also going to give him just a hint of the mustache. You can actually make this into a mustache, Poro. I made this into a mustache, Poro, and I don't remember if I put it on the DeviantArt. If I didn't, I would be putting it back on there. And these little facial details to show the center of the face of Poro. And a little bit of a whisker, just because I can. Just a little bit. Nothing too huge. And this Poro is, I think Poros are adorable. Not a lot of people. Well, a lot of people do, some people don't. It's all up to personal preference. And now we're gonna, before we finish, we are gonna redefine the dark lines around the feet. You don't have to do this if you don't want to. If you don't want to, you can go ahead and leave the video. Because that's actually the end of the video, pretty much. That's just refining this. Getting those digits in there. Making sure that the fur looks appropriate, which it does. Separating some things from other things with darker lines. Oh yeah. That is how you draw a Poro. And you know y'all can take your own artistic license with drawing a Poro. I took mine when I drew my original one, making the shape a little bit more bulky. As you can see, like, it's a lot more size to him than this one. This one looks more like a stuffed toy, but I think it's adorable. The horns are a little too crooked and big, but yeah, that would be the end of this video. It's rather late here where I am. I hope you all have a lovely rest of your night. And also, whenever you think an image is done, don't forget, you can always come back and edit it. Even if you already have it posted somewhere, you can always go back and edit it. And if you want, you can even leave a timestamp for this. With darker ones, just to make sure that you get all that nice detail in there. If you like detail, it's a good idea. If you really like detail, you know all this. Now, if you guys all enjoyed this video, I think my Poro is done though, so I'm going to actually save it. And that's our video for tonight. Good night, everybody!